Hello and welcome to my channel. Yes, it's me again. Guess what I'm making? Some bacon. Yes, I am making some bacon and I'm going to walk you through it step by step and show you how I make my bacon. You know, you don't want to be buying bacon in a stove all the time because there's no meat on it. There's no so much fat. Even though a little fat is okay, but I'm going to show you how to make your bacon at home. All right. Just keep watching. Okay. I went to the market and I got some pork belly. That's what you make bacon with. And I got about 5.5 pounds. So this is it here. And I cut the skin off because they didn't want to cut the skin for me. But so that was okay. But let's see. Let me get a knife. Yes, I cut the skin off. And I'm going to show you in another video how I cut the skin off. And I trim it off, took a lot of the grease off. And so this is it. This. And let me make a look at this. All right. Okay. For the, to make the bacon, since this is it's a long piece, so I'm going to cut this in half and make it 2 because I have to put that in a bag and I don't have a big bag for this, but I'll cut it up in half and okay. I had to cut the 2 pieces, and after I cut these, let me give you the ingredients for these. I have 2 tablespoons of kosher salt, 3 tablespoons of brown sugar, the curing salt, I have 1 teaspoon. You can get this on Amazon, and this is the package that come in. This is the one that I pick, but there's different kind. I have some black pepper, 1 teaspoon. I have 1 teaspoon of paprika, and I got some garlic that I'm just going to throw in there. Okay. So what I'll do, I mix all of these in a bowl and then I start doing it. Okay. All right. I'm going to put the salt, the sugar, the curing salt, because I don't want to put too much salt in there because I don't want my bacon salty, and some black pepper, the paprika, the one that I made, and I'm going to mix these together. It's not hard to make bacon, you just have to have time, you know, waiting, you're waiting and waiting and waiting. Yeah, so you're going to mix this together very well. Then what I do, I just rub it down with all of this. Turn it over. Do the same thing. Make sure you rub it everywhere. Do the same thing with this. I have to put it in a bag, so that's why I had to cut it, because I don't have a big bag to hold the whole long piece in for now. I will have to get another bag. I'll have to get a bag later. Okay. All right. So what I do, let me change this glove. And I will get another one and get a bag. I'm going to get both bags to put these in. Can you imagine making your own bacon? You don't have to go to the stove and buy any. Okay, this is the one-pound bag I'm going to use to put these in. Put this on the side. I'll put this in the bag. Lay it down flat. Get another bag. And I'll put this in the bag. And let me get this out of the way. Okay. Lay it flat in the bag. Okay, I have the rest of it. I'm going to just put it in there. Turn this over. Turn this over. Okay, this is the first step in making bacon. I'm going to take this and put it in the refrigerator for 7 to 10 days. And that will be in the refrigerator. But every day I will have to go and turn it over and massage it. And just for 7 to 10 days, you know, all depends on how many days you want it in there. And then when that is done, we're going to go to the next step. Okay. And then I say wait for two. Okay. I put a date on them and I'm going to take this and put it in the refrigerator. I'm going to put it in a bowl and just set it in the refrigerator for the 7 days. This is it. And every day we're going to check on it and turn it over. And we're just going to turn the bag over and just massage it, you know, make sure that seasoning is all in it. And then when the day come, we're gonna start eating bacon. Yes, you know, we were making bacon, right? And we had to season it and cure it and keep it in the refrigerator for 7 to 10 days. All right, I had it in the refrigerator for over 7 days, maybe 8, because I was busy. Maybe 9 days, but I'm gonna take it out now. This is stage two. I'm gonna rinse it out, and I'm gonna put it in another rack and let it, put it back in the refrigerator on cover, and let it stay there for maybe over 24 hours. So let me go and get it out of the refrigerator and bring it, and we can rinse it up and set it down. Okay. Here it is. We put it in the refrigerator. Okay. Let me uncover it. It was 2 bags. This one here, and this is the other one. So we're going to take this out of the bag. I had it curing in there for maybe 8 or 9 days, because I'm not counting anymore. So I will have to rinse this out and rinse all everything. I'll rinse it out good. And I'm going to put it back in the refrigerator and let it stay there overnight. And then the next day I'm going to put it on the grill and grill it very slowly. So here it is. I have been, you know, turning it over and massaging it every day for like 7 days and 8 days. So Here it is. I'm going to take it out and I'm going to rinse it out with some cold water. Let me get this out of here. Because it was a big piece, so I had to cut it up into two pieces. That's why we got two of them. So I'm going to rinse it out with some cold water. Out and I have it on a rack. I'm going to take this whole tray and put it in the refrigerator for 24 hours. Some people keep it for more than 24 hours. You know, if you don't have the time to grill it, let it stay in there. As long as it's in the refrigerator, it's fine. So I'm going to put this in the refrigerator and then we're going to come back next. That will be stage three to put it on the grill. So we still making bacon. That's the only part. This, you have to be patient making the bacon. You have to be very, very, very patient. So this is stage two. We finished with that. We're gonna take it and put it in the refrigerator and we're gonna come back next. We're grilling and then back in the refrigerator and then slicing it. So let's keep going. I'm gonna put it in the refrigerator right now. Okay, it have been over 24 hours and I'm gonna take the baking out of the refrigerator and I'm gonna put it in the oven. I'm using the oven because a lot of people, I mean, it's easy that way, but sometimes I put it in the grill. But today, the oven gonna work for me. So I'm gonna take it out of the oven now. I'm out of the refrigerator and then I'm gonna set the oven at 189. Maybe I might just make it 200 to make it less time. So I'm gonna set the temperature to 200 and then I'm gonna put that in here. Okay. Now it's on 200 and I'm gonna put it in the oven and let it stay there for about 4 hours. And I'm gonna get it out of the oven and put it back in the refrigerator and then I'm gonna cut my bacon. All right, let's go. Okay, this is it. I got it out of the refrigerator. I wanna take this and put it in the oven and it's gonna be in there baking for like 4 hours, 3 to 4, 5 hours. I'm gonna be checking it and turning it over. So this is, it take a long time making bacon, but you know, you have to be patient. And I'm gonna open the oven, put that in there. I'm gonna leave it on this rack and just put it in the oven. And it's gonna be in there for the next 4 hours. After 4 hours, I'll let you know where we're gonna go, what we're gonna do next. Okay, now we are here trying to cut our bacon up and we're gonna slice it up because after I took it out of the oven, I put it in the refrigerator for like 1 or 2 hours and then it was there. And then now it's time to start slicing bacon. I'm gonna take it out of the refrigerator and then we're gonna slice bacon, okay? All right, here it is. I took it out of the refrigerator and here's the bacon. Here is the meat. And I'm gonna put it on this side. We have to start slicing it from here. So I'm gonna put this on to the slicer. Let's see. I guess we'll put it this way. Okay. Okay, I put it on to 5 so I can start slicing the bacon. So this is it, and I'm gonna start slicing it now. I'm gonna turn it on. For 5.5 pounds, this is how much bacon we got. My friends are gonna have a lot of fun eating bacon. So I'm gonna take some and let me get a frying pan. Okay, now we're gonna try the bacon right now, okay? All right, I got the skillet on, it's getting hot. So I'm gonna put like different sizes there. Can you hear that? And I like these short pieces, so I'm gonna put some of this on. That's a lot of piece. You get one of the long ones and put that right there. All right, look at our bacon. Look at our bacon. I like these big pieces. All right, I'm gonna turn this stove off. Here is our bacon. Okay, now it's time for the taste test. Okay. All right, put this here. All right. I get this here. There's the bacon. It is still hot. I have to let it cool off first. Mmm. Tastes good. This is good. Mmm. Now you see, you can make your own bacon. Sorry. This is good. So next time, before you go to the market and buy bacon, because they're getting so expensive now, buy your pork belly and make yourself some bacon. Then I said, keep watching. There will be something new coming up again. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you. I need to eat another bacon. Oh my goodness. Mm. My friend's gonna enjoy this bacon. My daughter gonna enjoy it. This is good. Homemade bacon. Mm. I had to eat another piece, you know. Mm-hmm. Okay. But then I say, see you next time. Much for watching. I appreciate you. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to like, and do not forget to share. It's baking time. Let's eat bacon. Thank you so much for watching.